Now, if you've just bought a brand new Mercedes, you've probably heard of this, which is the Mercedes-Benz app. Now, it can do a whole world of things, from unlocking and locking your car remotely to locating it on a map, and you can even turn the heating on and cooling remotely on some selected models. So in this video today, we're going to go through a setup guide on how to link your car, activate your account, and turn on all of those digital extras. So let's check it out. Now, it's important to note what Mercedes-Benz you have. As always, and as I always mention on my channel, specs do vary around the world. So if you're not sure, chat with a local Mercedes-Benz dealership and they can give you tailored advice on your own car. However, as a general rule of thumb, if you bought a brand new car, they should have linked it for you and activated all the digital extras and kind of talked about it. But just in case they haven't, I'm going to show you how to do that in just a second. But the most important thing, if you bought a used car that's been owned by someone else, the previous owner should have removed it off their account, but if they haven't, you will need to contact a local dealer, provide proof of ownership and ID to verify that you are the new owner, and they'll get the old person removed and get you on there. Right, let's link up this car to my account. So once you're in your new car, you will see this on the screen, which says Mercedes Me and activate Mercedes Me. So we will go onto that in just a second, but before that, I'm just gonna say download the app first. So go onto the App Store or the Play Store, depending on your phone, search Mercedes-Benz, and as you can see here, I have it already downloaded. So open it up, and then you'll be presented with this screen. So you can either choose here, login or register, so just depending on if you have an account. For me, I know I have an account, so tap login, and then it'll ask you to fill in your email address or your mobile phone number, depending on what you've registered. I will just add, if you're going to use mobile phone number, make sure you add the country code. So for the UK, it's +44 and then 7. So just remove the 0. There we go, all signed in. Now you'll note that on my screen right here, there is already a car. Yes, this is my car. Sadly, this one isn't. So we're gonna add this car to my account. Now, if you're gonna add another car, lucky, lucky you, all we do is go to the picture of the car on the top left. Then at the bottom there, just tap add vehicle. Now there's a few ways you can do this. You can either do it via a QR code, as long as the car has MBUX. So this is the one with the Hey Mercedes voice assistant. You can also do this via the vehicle identification numbers. So that's the VIN. You'll find this either on the driver's door just down here, or just on the bottom of the windscreen over there, or you can get Mercedes-Benz dealer to do it. And as I said, if you've bought a new car, they may have already done this for you. Now for me, I'm going to do the QR code because this is the one of the easiest ones. Now when you do this, it'll ask, can the Mercedes-Benz app access the camera? And it's purely just for this purpose here. So I'm going to activate Mercedes Me. And of course, we will blur this QR code so you guys can't see it. There we go. Your vehicle has been successfully paired. It's as easy as that. Now, just under here, add your license plate number, I'm just going to leave that blank for this example. And then you'll notice underneath here, manage digital extras. You'll notice this will all be signing in while I do this. Now, digital extras, quite simply, are the extra things you get with your Mercedes. So these can be things like live traffic or use of the app or various different things that you can purchase to enhance your experience. If you guys want me to do a full video on every single digital extra, then of course, let me know in the comment section just down below. So for this, I'm just going to tap activate all, unless there's a specific reason why you only want to activate certain ones, then do activate selected extras, but I'm going to do activate all. Now on some selector cars, there's also a thing called Mercedes Me Charge. This is only found on plug-in hybrids and electric cars. I'm going to make a separate video on that one, so have a look for that one. I'll link that down below in the description and it'll be on the pop-up banner up above, because that's a video in itself. But for this one, I'm just going through the kind of main app interface. But that's it, it's all linked, and usually what Mercedes-Benz quoted, it can take up to 24 hours, but I have noticed that the latest multimedia systems do activate pretty quickly, and well, that's it all done. So before we go through the app, I just want to go through the profile setup in the car, because that's probably the most important bit for you guys. Then we'll quickly go through the app. Now the first thing you'll see on screen is unlock, and it'll have your name on there based on what you've put on the app. And you'll see it says enter your Mercedes Me PIN. Now, don't worry if you don't know this. Again, if you've set up your account for the first time, Mercedes will have emailed you or text you a PIN. Again, don't worry if they haven't. Very easy to reset on the app. I'll make a separate video on how you can do that. But basically, it's on the menu on the, I think it's on the top right-hand corner now. And then there's a reset PIN there in the settings section. but I'll get this logged in, so no peeking. Now this is the setup assistant, so it's just going to help you set up a few things. So I'll show you what to do here. All you do is tap start and then just basically follow all the steps. Now I've mentioned this in a few videos, certainly the tips and tricks ones before. This is basically that pin that you had to put in. By default, you have to put that in every time you get in the car. So if you don't want that, turn that off. Now I know some cars do have facial recognition over here, which is pretty cool. I think it's E-Class and S-Class. And then some I've noticed also have a fingerprint reader down there, which is quite handy. That is a replacement for the pin, but again, if you don't want to do any of that, just turn off access protection. Here you can put in your name. Now this, of course, as I said, will take it from your account, but if you want to put in a nickname or something, or even just remove your surname, then you can do that just here. Now this next page is called suggestions. Now this is thoroughly recommended if you are just using the car yourself. So if you're not giving it out to anyone, that's not being used by a company or anything like that, then there's no reason to have this off. This just purely helps suggest a few things on how it just makes your experience a lot better, where it can recommend certain aspects on the multimedia system. For example, on cars with the vertical screen, it'll have a thing called zero layer intelligently recommending a few things. This next one is where you can program in your home. So just go to enter address and then type in your postcode or road name or general area, depending on what you want to do. Now I'm just going to tap current position. So if you're doing this on your drive at home, then you can tap that. Although I don't live here, but just for this example, I'll do it here. So continue. And then here you can connect your phone if you wish to, but I'll skip that a bit just for now. So do connect device, connect via Bluetooth, which will actually activate Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as well on compatible cars. And then last couple of ones here, this one is called voice recognition, so you can actually teach it your voice to log into your profile. Again, I won't do that here, but if you do want to do that, just tap configure. And that's it done. So that is your profile set up. Now, if you want to create additional profiles, you can create up to 7 profiles per car, which is quite handy. And they're all accessed on this little bit up here, and just go to select new user. And yeah, that's how you add a new user, and just scan the QR code per phone that you're doing it. But now, next thing to have a look at is the Mercedes-Benz app, and just show you a few things on there. So this is the Mercedes-Benz app, and you'll notice that the layout has changed slightly over the past few years or so, and the most recent update is top left and top right. So for example, top right, if you tap in here, this brings up your profile, so your name, email, inbox for any messages, transactions and settings and things. And if we go back, go to the top left, this is how you can now cycle through your garage of your cars. Now if you're like me, I only have one car, but if you have multiple cars, I think you can have up to like 15 or 20 cars on there. So quite useful for a company if you run a fleet of them, for example. But yes, back to the home screen, and we'll go through all the various functions here. So as we scroll down, the first section here where it says doors open is basically notifications. So alerts and things that you might need to take note of. So in here you can see doors are open. So this door's open at the moment and the whole car is unlocked. Now underneath this is the battery remaining. So this is an electric car, so I think it says the fuel for petrol or diesel cars. And then underneath this is the remote controls. Now you can actually customize this, which I'll show you in a second, but you can see here it says unlocked, and you've got windows and then sunroof. And then the one with the fan is for your heating. So if you want to put heating or cooling on, as long as the car has an auxiliary heater or a heat pump, they are primarily found on plug-in hybrids or electric cars though. So sadly not on my own cars, it's just a petrol car, but very, very nice on cold mornings like today. But yes, go to customize, and you can even bring up lights up here and put this here. And you can then turn the lights on and off, just in case you're in a pitch black car park and you can't find your car. Just turn the lights on remotely, which I have done before, very useful. But as this is an electric car, I'm going to keep the heating there because that's definitely a nice luxury until this one goes back. Now this next thing is charging dashboard. This is related to Mercedes Me Charge, so I'm not going to run through that in this video. As I mentioned, there's a separate video in the description just down below. Now you might be wondering what the icons are along the bottom. Well, I'm glad you asked. We'll go through this second bit here. So in here shows you everything that the car can do on the Mercedes-Benz app. So you've got things like vehicle search and tire pressure. You can check the tire pressures of each individual wheel. It will tell you if there's a problem as well, which is quite handy. You can view service information and 12 volt battery information and that sort of thing. I'm not surprised why it says partially charged at the moment, because I keep on putting on my heated seat because it is mighty cold outside. So we'll get that charged back up when I drive in a minute. There's things like trip data. So that's all the information that you can view in here, just on the app. So individual journeys you've done and overall journeys over a set time. Miles per gallon as well for petrol and diesel cars, and then miles per kilowatt or watt hours per mile on the individual consumption. And there's other things as well like vehicle updates and eco driving and a few extra remote controls like digital key handover, which I have made a separate video about. I'll link that down below as well. The next section is charging. So in here is where you can view your charge status, and you can even set the pre-entry climate control to come on at a set time, which is quite handy. And you can even have different charging programs for home and work, and charge the battery up to a certain point at home, or do a different thing based on work, and even set up GPS things as well. Speaking of GPS, there's also a thing called geofencing. So yes, you can locate the car on a map, which is all controlled through the Mercedes-Benz app, but geofencing is very, very clever, because say I was going to park the car in this car park here, and if I do add, I can set that if the car leaves that area, I can get a notification if it enters the zone or if it exits the zone or both, and then you can even set this to do it at certain times. So pretty cool. So yes, you can see the car's location. So if I go back to this page here, notice this third icon on the bottom. This shows you the car's location, and where I am, sat almost in it, apparently. It's accurate to like a meter or so. This is also where you can send addresses to the car. So if you use the Mercedes-Benz multimedia system, the sat-nav in there, as in not Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, you can send addresses. So let me go to, I don't know, let's say my local Mercedes-Benz dealer just up the road, send to car, and I'm gonna send this to this car, the EQA. Now, it used to take, literally, it used to take about a few seconds, but now it happens within a second. So it's mighty quick. One tap.
Your route is being calculated.
That's so easy. You can do this from home as well. You don't have to be sat in the car. So you can send it to the car and it'll just do it when you jump in. So very, very nice. On this page as well is where you can also search for charging stations. I do cover a bit of that in the Mercedes Me Charge video, which again is linked down below. The final thing on the Mercedes-Benz app is on the bottom right-hand corner, which is the shop or the store. So in here, you can actually go in and purchase different things to enhance your experience on the Mercedes. And basically, this actually shows you everything that the car can do on the kind of Mercedes-Benz app and Mercedes Me world of things, all the digital extras. Now, some things are included for free for a set time, so it does vary around the world. But in the UK, as a general rule of thumb, on brand new cars from what I've seen, you get the app free for 3 years, map updates and live traffic free for 3 years as well. There are some other things that vary, like in-car office, which again, I have a separate video on. But in here, you can basically see here, fairly long term on those things there. And then there's a few extra things that you can add, like dash cam as well. Again, I've got another video on that one as well. But yes, guys, that is the Mercedes-Benz app. But we are not done, because Mercedes have also released an update to the Apple Watch. Let's show you how to do that. So yes, Mercedes now have introduced the Apple Watch. Now, fun fact, they actually did have an Apple Watch app a long, long time ago. It was, I don't know, might have been maybe 2015, 2016. And I think it was just a bit early for its time, but it's back now. So let's have a look. So menu, let's find Mercedes-Benz, and here, verify this code. So I need to put this in here. I'll obviously make sure this is blurred so you guys can't see it, because I don't want you controlling either this car or my car, but bear with me while I just get this linked up. And this is all of it linked. So now, I've linked my own car just because I feel like, well, this one goes back soon. But yeah, look, A180 AMG Line Premium. Got my fuel there. So swipe across, I can unlock and lock it. And I can even locate it on a map. Obviously, I'll blur this bit so you guys can't see where I live. But yeah, look, It even knows the compass location. So yes, my car is in fact over there. So yeah, pretty cool. 56 minute walk though, so I'm not going to do that. And then the last page just gives you loads of vehicle status. So vehicle locked, doors locked, hood or bonnet, and trunk, parking brake and windows. But yeah, there's the Mercedes-Benz app. So I'm sure it might vary depending on the specification of the car, but there we go. Good to see it back in the watch world of apps. So there we go then guys, that concludes this week's video on the Mercedes-Benz app. Let me know your thoughts below, and of course, as always, if you have any suggestions for future videos, let me know in the comment section down below. But thank you so much for watching. Until next time, see you then.